What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back for another Game of Thrones Season 7 update video. The Game of Thrones community is buzzing right now after Entertainment Weekly just posted several new photos that were taken during the filming of Season 7. I don't want to waste any of your time today, so let's get right into this. Comment below and tell me what you think is going on in each of these new photos. The first photo is of Daenerys Targaryen, and would you look at the size of her dragon Drogon? I mean, holy shit. A report did come out a few weeks ago that said Daenerys' dragons would be the size of 747 airplanes. Well, it doesn't look like they were kidding, were they? Daenerys looks so small on the back of Drogon right now, it's kinda hilarious. But this is a spectacular image. This is most likely the scene that was mentioned in the plot leak. Apparently, at some point next season, Daenerys is supposed to ambush Jaime Lannister and his Lannister army, as they are marching back from Highgarden. We've seen a few photos from this battlefield already. Daenerys is supposed to kill Randall and Dickon Tarly next season with her dragons. Jaime Lannister is also supposed to be nearly killed as well, until he is saved by Bronn. It's hard to say if all these details are going to be correct or not, but I absolutely believe this image will be from the battle that's going to take place mid-season, which is kind of crazy for Game of Thrones standards. They typically feature their biggest battle scenes at the end of the seasons, usually during episode 9 each year. But the director that has been seen on set filming these battle scenes is the same director that's going to be directing episodes 4 and 5, so we can potentially get a mid-season battle that's supposed to be the biggest battle Game of Thrones has ever done. They hired hundreds of extras and nearly 100 horses were brought on set to film these scenes, which is more than what they used for the Battle of the Bastards. And by the look of this photo, I think we're going to be in store for something even more epic, now that Daenerys' dragons will be involved in these battles. I cannot wait for this scene to take place. Can you imagine Jon Snow in the middle of a battle, with Dany's dragons flying over top of him, providing aerial support? I think that would be absolutely amazing. But let's move on to the next photo, though, which is a photo of Jon Snow on horseback. He appears to be leaving Winterfell, in my opinion. If you look at his hand, it does appear that he is waving goodbye to someone, most likely waving goodbye to Sansa. I think this is when Jon Snow leaves Winterfell to head south and meet up with Daenerys Targaryen on Dragonstone. But let me know what you think's going on here. If you think something else is going on, comment down below. But to me, it appears that he is indeed leaving Winterfell, which I think we all knew would happen at some point next season. We know he needs dragonglass, and we know he needs men. And in order for him to acquire these things, he's gonna have to leave Winterfell and make some moves. The next photo is of Sansa Stark and Littlefinger. This is the exact same scene taking place that we got a glimpse of last time HBO released a few photos. This is just a different angle taken from the courtyard of Winterfell. I think this is gonna take place after Jon is gone and goes down to Dragonstone, which I think Littlefinger is gonna see as an opportunity to try and manipulate Sansa even more and get her to turn against Jon. Littlefinger needs Sansa in control of the North because he assumes she will be much easier to deal with than Jon. But in my opinion, Littlefinger's gonna be in for a big surprise next season when the student, Sansa Stark, surpasses the teacher, Peter Baelish. I think Sansa's gonna end up outplaying Littlefinger at his own game, which should eventually lead to him being exposed and ultimately executed. As cool of a character that Littlefinger is, I think we are all patiently waiting for the day to come to where he must pay for his crimes, and it's gonna be glorious. The next photo is in the throne room at King's Landing. Once again, this is the same scene that we got a peek at recently when HBO released their previous photos. This is just a different angle of Cersei and Jaime Lannister, most likely meeting with someone. I think this is when Cersei and Euron meet for the first time and discuss their terms of an alliance. We know from other photos that Euron's gonna arrive in King's Landing with a few prisoners that Cersei would love to get her hands on. Not to mention Cersei and Euron both need a new alliance. So it's gonna be a perfect fit for these two psychos to come together and wreak some more havoc before their inevitable deaths. But comment below if you think something else is going on here too. I'd love to hear what you have to say about this. And the next photo is of Arya Stark riding on horseback. And I must say, even though Arya and Ned Stark aren't related in real life, it's almost scary how similar she looks to her father now. I mean, Arya is a spitting image of Ned. It's crazy how much they actually look alike. They did a hell of a job casting these two to be family members. But anyway, I think this is going to be one of the most emotional scenes next season, because I think this could be Arya arriving in Winterfell. With the Stark theme playing in the background, and Arya arriving and standing within Winterfell's walls again, it's going to be so emotional and satisfying to see her make it home. I'm really looking forward to this scene. And the next photo shows Tormund standing in Winterfell, and I'm not sure exactly what's going on here. This could be the same scene where Jon leaves Winterfell for Dragonstone. This could just be Tormund seeing Jon off as he leaves, but I can't guarantee that, of course. But it does appear that Brienne is standing in the back there, wearing her armor. So we do know that Brienne makes it back to Winterfell in one piece, which is a good thing. And speaking of Brienne, the last photo is of Brienne of Tarth, who looks to be very happy in this scene, even though they're not actually filming at this time. But she better hold on to this thought, because we know that much darker days are on the horizon now that winter is here. And I'm not too sure what's going on in this photo either, to be honest with you. There isn't really much to go on here. This could also be at Winterfell, but I don't remember seeing those small curtains there before, so maybe they added that for this season, or perhaps she could be somewhere else. If you have anything to add to this photo, let me know down in the comments. I always appreciate those of you that can pick up on a few details that I might have missed. But that's gonna do it for today, folks. I gotta cut this video kinda short. I'm sorry I didn't get it out a little bit sooner to you. I'm actually at work right now, but as soon as I received these photos, I immediately took my lunch break. That way I could record this and get it out to you as soon as possible. Thanks for stopping by and watching this video. Thank you to all my Patreon supporters as well. I love all you guys, and I'll see you down below. Bye.